erratic.
Man, what you want, man?
Hey, yay, right after this, I'm gonna say you're crazy. I'm gonna take your family away from you.
Unhinged.
Hulu does not love you, Kim. Disney does not love you, Kim. Come home, Kim. Come home to Christ.
Downright dangerous.
Every human being has something of value that they brought to the table, especially Hitler.
Kanye West's career plunging to a frightening new low during a chaotic interview with far-right conspiracy theorist Alex Jones.
I don't think Hitler was a good guy. I get the Hugo Boss uniforms, amazing. But, I mean, just because you're in love with the design, you're a designer, can we just kind of say, like, you like the uniforms, but that's about it.
There's a lot of things that I love about Hitler.
Jones, for the first time in his life, trying to be the voice of reason.
West appearing alongside his new sidekick, Holocaust denier, and white supremacist Nick Fuentes, the same guy he took along to meet Donald Trump last week.
Trump loved Nick. He looked at me and said, "Where did you find this kid?"
As Outrage grew, West hammered what could be the final nail in his coffin, tweeting a picture of the Star of David intertwined with the Nazi swastika.
Oh my God.
The tweet prompted Elon Musk to ban the rapper from Twitter. West hitting back on Instagram today, accusing Musk of being born from a Chinese cloning program. It's the latest in a string of increasingly erratic behaviour over the last few months, forcing Adidas, Gap and Vogue to sever ties with the rapper.
I could say anti-Semitic things and Adidas can't drop me.
I ain't saying she a gold digger.
And while Kanye's made no secret of his battle with bipolar disorder over the years...
There's some cases of bipolar where people go low. I'm one that goes high.
It's one thing to steal Taylor's moment.
I'm let you finish.
It's another to spew hate and embolden the alt-far-right movement with an enormously influential figurehead as he launches his 2024 bid for the White House.
These little neo-Nazis are having the best week they've had in a long time. Yeah. Their ideas are spreading everywhere on social media. They feel important. They feel emboldened.
So can anything save Kanye from himself?
I like Hitler.
Our entertainment correspondent, Hyla, joins us now from LA. Hyla, I'm no doctor, I'm not a psychologist. This is not a formal diagnosis, but I think everyone assumes that something isn't right with Kanye at the moment. Why isn't anyone intervening in this?
Who? I mean, you're talking about one of the most wealthy people in the world. He kind of has autonomy to do whatever he wants, and he's still making a lot of money for a lot of people. I'm unclear, without him actually breaking the law, who exactly is supposed to step in. I'm sure people have tried. I mean, you know, just a few weeks ago when we were talking about Kanye, he was doing screen grabs of people like Diddy, who was like trying to talk him off the ledge. And he was just putting that right out in the public. I think people have. The question is, who can do it in an effective way? And I'm unclear until he does something illegal that's going to stop.
Well, Hyla, you talk about his apparent autonomy to be able to do whatever he wants. So in that, there seems to be this fringe minority then that's getting empowered by his words. Have there been any real-world consequences?
Yeah, of course. I mean, I think it was just this week, the former prime minister of Israel, Benjamin Netanyahu, asked Donald Trump and other officials to please, like, you know, say that that you're against anti-Semitism, you're against what Kanye's saying, lots of silence from that crowd. And then you have real-world consequences. The FBI has talked about elevated threats, serious threats. Security has gone up at synagogues in New York City and New Jersey. And I was just reading a tweet about a mom who has her kid in school where they have to have armed guards now. So this is having real world consequences.
Hyla, he's been kicked off just about every piece of social media you can imagine. Have there been any calls, though, for places like Spotify to dump his music or radio stations to stop playing it?
Yeah, of course. This reminded me a little bit of R. Kelly because it was the same conversation. And I remember Spotify tried to make some moves pulling music and then they took a step back and didn't mess with that. And basically, I think it was Daniel Ek, the CEO of Spotify, talking about this a few weeks ago. And he says, you know, technically, Kanye's music is not violating our policies, so it's up to the labels to remove that music. So basically, you know, passing the buck. What's also interesting is a Billboard magazine just announced last week that Kanye is the number one most played male artist of this year. And there's no irony in the fact that he's the number one Christian artist this year.
And amazingly, he's still committing to a 2024 run for president. The campaigns of unlikely presidents have been dismissed before. Could this one take off?
Okay, so the last election, when Kanye ran under the birthday party, he got 0.03% of the vote. And I don't think that the Hitler endorsement is really going to drive up the vote count. I think at this point, anyone that seriously talks about him in a presidential capacity, that's just pure clickbait. I think it's trash.
You might also split the Trump vote, Hyla. I mean, that's the other aspect of this. There's more than an informal connection between some of these figures. We'll leave it there. Thanks very much for staying up late for us.
Thanks, guys. I appreciate it.